You might be sculpting something really awesome, but if the presentation is terrible, no one's gonna notice. So I'm gonna show you three super simple things that instantly can make a ZBrush work in progress look more professional without even rendering, compositing, or any extra tools. Hi, if you're new around here, my name is Pablo Munoz. I'm a 3D concept artist and educator, and I help artists level up their skills in the world of 3D in a way that is fun, clear, and actually doable. And in this video, I'm gonna show you three things that I'm gonna make a huge difference in the way that you present your ZBrush progress shots. Let's go ahead and jump straight into it. All right, so here is a quick work in progress from a character that I've been developing. Again, it is still a work in progress, but the way that you present things, even if it is a sketch or a work in progress, it has a huge impact in the way that people read the character or the impact that it has when you share it online. Now, of course, this one has a very bright color and it has this complementary kind of like contrasting colors. So it might not be the way that you want to go about your work in progress, but even if you do something like this, this is something that looks a lot more professional, a lot more captivating if you want to share this in social medias and that sort of thing. That if you were to present something like this, right? So this is the type of screenshots and things that I usually see online and that people share, and you know, they ask for feedback or they share their work in progress, and that's totally fine. It is, you understand what is happening, but it's not the best way of presenting your thing. So there are three things that you want to keep in mind to improve your presentation, even if it is at a work in progress level. So compare this one on the left-hand side with the one on the right-hand side. This looks a lot cleaner, a lot sharper. You understand the volumes a lot more, and then it is easier to provide feedback and actually get people interested in the work that you're doing compared to this one. All right. So again, it's something that it might be really trivial, but it is. I see it all the time. So I want to show you these three things that are really helpful. So let's jump into ZBrush here. And this is essentially the screenshot that I just showed you. And it is terrible for a few reasons. So I have condensed this technique and this method to present your work in ZBrush in a three-letter acronym, so DFM. So the DFM is kind of like something that it's a little bit easier to remember, and every time that you want to share a work in progress, always think about that, DFM. So D stands for document, so you need to make sure that your document is correct. The F stands for framing, which is super important, and the M stands for material. And it's just kind of like referring to choosing the right material for what you want to show. All right, so let's go ahead and go back here into the full screen, and I'll show you how easy it is to take something like that and reframing, rework it so that the work in progress is actually a lot better. So the first thing in the DFM acronym is D, which again is for document. So the first thing I want to do is I want to show you, in fact, let's go ahead and zoom in a little bit more. And actually, before we continue, let's go ahead and switch to the standard UI so that you can follow along a little bit easier. So all the jagged edges that you see here, that has to do with the size of the document. So if you click on this actual button right here, ZBrush is gonna show you the actual size of the document and the resolution of it. It's kind of like in Photoshop when you see the full resolution in the viewport, but if you wanna have like the document kind of like filling the entire space, you might wanna zoom in and out. So that way you can work like this. However, when you do this, you start to see those jagged edges and the pixelation. I'm gonna exaggerate it so that it is very, very evident. So you have all that pixelation. It is still a 3D object, right? But you see all that pixelation because it has to do with the resolution of your document. All right, so when we click on actual, this is much better. However, you can still see a little bit of the pixelation. It's gonna be a little bit harder to see, but you can still see it on the edges of this character. So the first thing I like to do is make sure that my document is set to double the size of what I wanna share. And again, it's a very quick operation. You don't have to spend too much time on it. In fact, I have a macro for this. But all you need to do is double it the size and then click on AAHalf, which is going to show you an anti-aliased version of whatever is in the canvas. So don't worry, if this is getting a little bit too complicated, all you need to do is go to document. You want to click on this W size. This means that it's going to create the document based on the size of your window. So let's do that first. And let's click on new document. I'm going to click on no. And now I'm going to click and drag to bring in my character again. All right. So now if I click on actual, you see this is the actual size of the document, and you can still see a little bit of that pixelation. So the ideal would be to present or to screenshot, if you want, your concept by clicking on AAHalf, but that obviously reduces the document. So step one was to simply click on W size, click on new document, and create a document, right? Now what I want to do is click on double. So that is going to create double the size of this document. Again, Control N to clear. Click and drag, and let's bring in this character again. All right, so now if I click on AAHalf, we're actually going to have the full document, or like the full window that we can work with. And look at how different this is. Everything looks super nice and crisp. So that is the idea with the D for the DFM method. So D is for document. Make sure that your document, it has the right resolution. Again, you can turn this into a macro and it's a lot easier, and make sure that you always have this before you share it. The second thing I like to do, and this is more of a personal preference, is to remove this horrible background that sometimes is a little bit distracting. Again, when I'm presenting my characters or my work in progress, I want people to focus on what I'm presenting. I don't want to have any distractions. So what I want to do is go to document, and I want to go to this range, and I'm going to reduce that to zero. So that removes that gradient, and we have now a cleaner sort of background. And that's it. In terms of the document, that's all you need. Now, the next letter in the acronym is the framing, and that is super, super simple. I'm not going to spend too much time on it. The idea is to find the right angle for the screenshot. Even if it is a work in progress, it is ideal if you find the right angle. So in practical terms, one thing to avoid is try to let the composition of your character breathe a little bit. So if you compare these two, let's go back in here. We have a couple of things that are uncomfortable, let's say, when you look at this image. So for example, the head of this character gets cropped here at the top. Also, you have this, you know, the brush going on top of this screenshot. So it's just, it's kind of like ugly to see it like this. And it is distracting as well. Plus what we talked about, the gradient as well as the pixelation. But in terms of the framing, try not to crop the head. Allow the composition to have a little bit of a breather here. So I usually do this with anything to do with a character. So I let the composition breathe that way. I leave a little space here on top of the head. And of course, making sure that there's no UI in the way. All right. So even like this, this is a better shot, right? So that has to do with the framing. Very, very important. And to finalize it before I take the screenshot, I want to talk about the material selection. So far throughout this video, I've been using this Matcap RedWax, which is a good Matcap, but I personally don't like it. I don't like it because it exaggerates things that are not in there. Or in other words, it emphasizes volumes that are not as pronounced or as intense that are not in there. So let me just show you what I mean. If I just go ahead and press Shift S to drop that in the canvas, and I switch to a simple material like the basic material right here, you see that there's certain crevices, certain things that are not as pronounced because of the material. So this is why this third acronym in this method is super important. Make sure that you choose the right material. And if you like the red wax, by all means, but I would just say, if you want to show volumes, right? If you want to do a work in progress and you're working on an anatomy or refining volumes of your character, the best way to do is to choose something like this basic material, the most basic stuff, right? You can also choose basic material too, and that gives you a little bit of a shine. And that's also a really good option, especially if you're working with hard surface details or anything that has like a sharp edge, because this is going to bring that nice reflection around it. And so that's another gray material. And when in doubt, if you don't know which one to choose, I would just suggest to go for either the matcap gray, which again, it gives you a nice read of the volumes. Now, if you're using one of the latest versions of ZBrush, there is a material that is actually pretty cool that comes with it, which is called the Monster Clay Matte Green or the Monster Clay Matcap Brown. So if you click any of these ones, that will give you a nice material to render or to take a screenshot of your character or whatever you're working on that shows the volumes nicely, right? But like I said, when in doubt, I just go with the basic material that gives you plenty to understand the work in progress. And that's it. You now have your nice document, you have a nice framing, and you have a material that actually works. If for whatever reason you have Polypaint in your work in progress, I do have Polypaint on this guy, so I'm going to turn this on. So I've been working on the Polypaint, right? If I want to show this material might not be the right one to show that Polypaint. So that's why it's important to choose the right material for whatever you want to show. In this case, something like either the flat color, if you want to show just the texture, or the skin shade 4 will work better, because that way you can show a little bit of the volume as well as the Polypaint, right? So in this case, I want to keep things simple, and I just want to go back to the basic material. All right, so those are the main three things that are very important when presenting a character or a concept or anything that you're doing in ZBrush to look a little bit more professional. And it's very, very simple. Again, DFM, document the right size, framing, that's ultimately the composition, even if it is a work in progress, make sure that's right. And the M for material, make sure that the material is the adequate to present whatever you want to present, whether it's Polypaint or refining volumes, whatever the case might be, make sure that fits with the presentation. Now, to finalize things, because I did show you something else, let me just bring it here. So I did show you this bit right here. This is nothing fancy. I didn't render it anything outside of ZBrush. This is actually just an extra couple of tweaks, which I would consider this to be some bonuses on this video. So let's go ahead and do that just to show you how easy this is. And in fact, I'm just going to go ahead and chuck this in here so you have it as a reference. So you can see it's the same thing. Well, let's put it in. Okay. So if you want to do something that it's a little bit more attention grabbing, especially to share it on social medias and that sort of thing, you can do something like this if it goes with the visual language that you are trying to create. So in my case, it's very simple. I'm going to go ahead and choose a color like yellow, and maybe more like an orangey tone like that. So once I chose it here from the palette, I'm going to go to document and I'm going to click once on this back color. So if I click once, ZBrush is going to grab automatically whatever I selected here in this primary color. Alternatively, you can just click and drag anywhere that you want, but I find it a lot easier to just select what I want, then go to document and click once and just basically get that color. It's a little bit lighter than this one. So let's just make it a bit darker and try it again. All right, that's a little bit closer. Perfect. So now we have the document. Again, part of the DFM, we have the document. The framing, I'm happy with this. And now the material, we're just going to adjust it, right? So let's go ahead and select maybe like a blue tone like that. And this one has a little bit of a shine that I created. So that's probably using the basic material too. So let's try to find something like this. And you'll see that even if I push the colors, the one that I have on the right-hand side looks a little bit brighter than this one. That has to do with the NPR filters. And I have a few videos in my channel where I show you how to tweak NPR filters and how to take advantage of that sort of non-photorealistic filters in the render within ZBrush, that once you set it up, you can save it in there and just leave it. And once you render your work in progress, then they will appear in there. So check those videos, but I'm going to go back in here and I'm going to show you how easy it is to tweak this one without the need of those NPR filters. So I'm going to go ahead and open up the left palette and I'm going to drop my material on the left-hand side. So in the material, here's where we can change a few things. I'm going to go to the modifiers and I'm going to take the diffuse one and I'm going to push it up. So the diffuse is basically how much, let's say, light is being diffused. So if we push this up, we basically increase that brightness, right? So that's roughly what I have in there. All right, something like this. And within the material modifiers, you can actually adjust the level of specularity as well. So if this is a little bit too shiny for you, you can reduce the specular here a little bit, or you can increase it a lot more. I like the subtle highlights, so I'm going to keep this like so. And you can also reduce or increase the amount of, like, the sharpness of that specularity by changing the specular curve. So if you click on this, you will be able to decrease that. So that way it sort of like spreads that shininess, if you will, or you can sharpen that and it will become very, very, almost like a wet material, right? So again, I like kind of like a middle ground. And those are like two very simple things that I just did. Well, three if you count the color. So choose a color that you want, increase the diffuse, tweak the specular, that's it. You have something that looks a lot cleaner. And not only that, it is within ZBrush, you don't have to do anything in rendering, compositing. You can just rotate around, take another screenshot, take another shot like this, and that's it. So to prove my point that this is a lot more interesting, I'm just going to go ahead and show you in terms of screenshotting this, what it would look like. So I'm going to do kind of like a close-up with a nice framing just to show a little bit of the face of this character. So I'm going to make sure that my UI or my brush is out of the way. So I'm going to put it around here and I'm going to screenshot this. And now that I have the screenshot, I'm going to go to Photoshop and paste it in there. And I'll go back to ZBrush and then let's find another nice sort of maybe something like this, another screenshot. There we go. Let's do a screenshot of that. Let's go back to Photoshop and paste it in there. Now, the first one came with the thumbnail in here, but that's okay. I'm going to get rid of that anyway. So I'm going to reduce it so that we can frame this again a little bit better. Now that I'm in Photoshop, I want to add a little bit more of that sort of breathing room that I mentioned before here on the head. So I'm going to place that in there. And then let's take the second one. And that is going to show more of the body or the work that I've done on maybe the pose or something like that. And just in terms of the composition, this is an extra tip for you. If the character is kind of like looking towards the right, or both screenshots are looking towards the right, that sort of pushes people, viewers' attention towards the right, right? Or kind of like leaks the composition. So I'm going to take this one and I'm going to flip it. So Control T, right click and flip horizontal. That way we can sort of put it in there. That's much better. And then in the background, I'm just going to select the same color that I have in my background and fill that, right? So this takes a few seconds, and this is as a screenshot or as a work in progress is a lot more powerful and a lot more interesting to see that something like this, right? Of course, we can get rid of that. But you know, if you compare doing a screenshot like this, even if you share it in social media or in a community like the one that we have, this is going to be awful compared to something like this. And it takes just a few more minutes to set it all up. And you'll have a lot more fun. And believe me, it's a much better way to present even a simple work in progress. All right, and to wrap up this video, I wanna show you some extra resources that could help you in the way that you present your characters, your progress, anything that you do in ZBrush. Let's go ahead and go back in here. And I'm gonna switch to ZBrush. This is another project, or kind of like the project that I saved before we did all the changes in here. So if you're at this point, let's say, and you work with the RedWax, again, nothing wrong with that. I just personally don't like it. But if you want to work with that, that's fine. So when you get to the point that you want to share your screenshot and your work in progress, and you can change the material. So of course, you have the ability to change this in ZBrush, and you can choose a bunch of things that come with ZBrush as well. However, I have some resources that you can download for free as well. So I have these presentation materials. All of these ones are on the website, and there's going to be a link as well in this video. I have a few that are for sculpting. So for example, if I double click on this one, that gives you I think this is a cleaner, simple way to sculpt that allows you to visualize some of the volumes a little bit better, but it's also a good one for presentation. This is one of my favorites as well. So there's a bunch of them, and they're, like I said, they're all free and you can just try them out. Now, if you like these ones, there's also a hard surface as well. So I'm gonna open this one up. This one is a pretty cool one that gives you kind of like a copper material. All of these ones, again, I'm just showing you things that are free on the website. You can just go ahead and download them. This one is excellent to visualize some of those details, those crevices in there, just because it has a little bit of a darker color, as you can see here in the crevices. And if you like to play around with this type of presentation materials, I will invite you to try out some other stuff like the comic material. So again, all of these ones are free. You can just go ahead and choose maybe this comic Wolverine. Maybe this is a little bit too much. You know, but there's some of them that are really, really easy, really, really clean to create this type of renders. And maybe we can change this to be white, right? So this can create a nice sort of like imprint, maybe for a tattoo or, you know, even like a t-shirt design, that sort of thing. Even if it is a presentation render, this helps. All right, so that's it for this video. Let me know how you go with this technique and feel free to share your progress in our community in Discord. Cheers.